All right, Brio, so we are just, I have posted your lyric sheet for Before You Go in Canvas. If you have a printer at home, print this off. If you do not have a printer, I already have paper copies of this in the office waiting for you to come and pick up, okay? But we're going to go through this today. We're gonna make a few markings in our music. We're gonna listen to the song again. So follow along in your lyric sheet with us today, okay? Here we go.
Still by the wayside, like everyone else. I hate you, I hate you, I hate you, but I was just kidding myself. Our every moment, I started a place. Cause now that the corner lies, you were the words that I needed to say. When you hurt under the surface, like troubled water running cold. Well, time can heal, but this won't.
First one, ready? So here's how this is going to work. Each verse is going to get broken up into solos like we've talked about before. So I'm going to show you exactly how those verses are going to get broken up. So the first and second lines of verse 1, I fell by the wayside like everyone else. I hate you, I hate you, I hate you, but I was kidding myself. I was just kidding myself. Draw a line underneath that second line.
What?
Second line, I hate you, I hate you, I hate you, but I was just kidding myself. Draw a line all the way underneath those words.
Okay?
And that is, and then I want you to put a 1 out to the side like this. Okay?
See, there's a 1 out to the side over here.
Okay? That is going to be verse 1. Here, I'll turn my camera, my dog camera. Okay, like this. Alright? Then, underneath, because now that they're gone, all I hear are the words that I needed to say. You're going to draw a line underneath that. And that is going to be verse 2. Or solo 2, I should say. That's going to be solo 2. Now these words down, these three lines here, when you hurt under the surface like troubled water running cold, well, time can heal, but this won't. I want you to put a star out to the side there because all of us are going to sing that. The whole choir is going to sing that. So put a star out to the side of those three lines. We're all going to sing that, okay? Then when we get down to the chorus, this is everyone is going to sing the chorus, okay? Now, everybody with me so far?
No.
Okay? Now verse 2. Let's look at verse 2. Okay? We're going to divide this one into two solos as well. So here we go. Underneath the second line of verse 2, you're going to draw a line all the way underneath that says, the line that says, went little by little by little until there was nothing at all. Draw a line underneath there. That's going to be verse 3. Okay? And then draw another line underneath, but all I can think about is seeing that look on your face. Draw a line underneath that. All of that, those two lines there, that's going to be solo 4. Okay, so this is solo 3, solo 4. And then just like on the first verse, when you hurt under the surface like troubled water running cold, well, some can heal, but this won't. We're all going to sing that, so put a star out to the side there, okay?
Are we all singing the chorus?
Yes.
Okay? Yeah. I mean, it is one person singing with their song, what do you expect?
All right. Now, we're all going to sing the chorus, of course. We come down to the bridge. Depending on how many of you guys want to try out for solos, we can separate this into solos, but my preference is that all of us sing the bridge together. So for now, we're gonna do both. I want you to put a line underneath the second line of the bridge. Underneath, if I'd have to let my walls come down, put a line under that. This would potentially be two solos here. But for right now, the plan is for all of us to sing that, okay? So put a star out next to the bridge. And then obviously the chorus, we're all singing the chorus together. Okay?
Copy?
Now, let me talk to you really, really quickly about how solos work. Okay? If you want to try out for a solo, then that is not something that I force you to do. That is something that you choose to do. I am never going to force somebody to do something that they're not comfortable doing. Okay? So, if you want to try out for a solo, do it. Now, let's say that you're a person that's not trying out for a solo, and you really, really should, and it's dumb that you're not trying out for a solo. I'm going to come up to you and be like, dude, you're dumb. You need to try out for a solo. No, I wouldn't really say that you were dumb. But I'm going to come up and I'm going to encourage you to sing, to try out for a solo. Now, I want you to think about why I would do that. Why would I encourage you to try out for a solo?
Oh.
How would I do that? Yes.
Because it helps you, like, Well, it especially if we're like singing in front of people, then it kind of like you kind of get nervous, and it'll help like with your like fright, and it'll help you understand and stuff.
Now, if you have a teacher, hey Brian, please stop doing that. If you have a teacher that encourages you to kind of step out and do something a little extra and push yourself a little bit, should you go home and maybe really kind of give that some consideration and some thought, like, hey, Miss Ritter thinks that I would be really good at this. I mean, at first thought, that makes me super duper nervous. And my gut reaction is I don't want to do it. But if Miss Ritter thinks I can do it, maybe I should. And I want you, if I come to you and I encourage you to try for a solo, please don't dismiss it flippantly and like, no, I would never do that. I want you to go home and I want you to give it some thought. And I want you to think about my motives behind it. It is not to force you to do something that you're not comfortable with. It is to encourage you to continue working and honing something that you are good at. Because some people, they never get that extra little push from a teacher when they're really talented. And then maybe they wind up quitting because they never get that kind of little bit of encouragement that maybe they need. Now, here's the other thing about solo tryouts. Hey, Dane, here's your goal. You're going to sit still and you're not going to make any noise while I'm talking, okay? Thank you. All right, now, soloists, it does not matter a hill of beans to me if you're a 7th grader or you're an 8th grader. Doesn't matter. 7th graders or 8th graders, neither of you gets preferential treatment. If you're a 7th grader and your solo sounds the best, then I'm going to give it to you. That's the way it should work. Would you agree with that?
Yeah.
Whoever sings it the best deserves it. Now, here's the only time that age plays any kind of factor in it. If I had a 7th grader and an 8th grader and they were neck and neck and I could not decide between the two because they were both so fantastic, in that instance, I might choose the 8th grader over the 7th grader only because they're an 8th grader. Does that make sense?
Why?
Because they have more experience.
Because they've been in choir with me and because it's their 8th grade year and I would like to give them that experience. And the 7th grader, you've already failed. You're already making noise. And the 8th grader, or I'm sorry, the 7th grader would have next year that they could try again. Does that make sense? That is the only time that I might factor in age. Otherwise, I do not care if you're a 7th grader or 8th grader. I remember sitting in my middle school choir classroom and we were all allowed to try out for a solo, but our choir teacher never picked 7th graders, ever, to do anything. It was always the 8th graders. And I remember sitting there thinking like, but that 7th grade guy sounded so much better than that 8th grade guy. Why did she choose the 8th grader? I don't get that. Okay? So,
Do you tell it?
No, it's not my place to do that. Okay? So, I just remember thinking like, man, I wouldn't do, if I was ever a choir teacher, I wouldn't do that. And I don't. Because whoever was the best, that's the person that deserves it. Okay? So, 7th graders, I tell you that, 7th graders and 8th graders, I tell you that because it's an equal playing field. It doesn't matter to me if you're a 7th grader or an 8th grader. Whoever has the best audition has the best audition. Okay? That's the fair way to do it. Okay. If you try out for a solo, do you have to sing it in front of the class? Yes, you do, because that's real life. If you're going to do a solo, you're going to have to sing it in front of people. Okay, and I have to know from the very get-go if you are capable of doing that. Okay, so yes, you'll have to stand in front of the class and sing it for me. Now, you don't have to stand here and face everybody and sing to the audience, but you do have to stand up here and sing to me. Okay, and that will be by yourself. It will be in front of everybody. That's why, like I said, no one is forced to try out for a solo, but you have to do a real-world solo audition where you sing it in front of people. Okay? Yes.
If we try out for one and we don't get it, can we try out for another one?
Well, what I do is I typically have everybody try out on the same solo. And then I will, knowing what your voice does, I will put you in the place that is, go to the hallway.
That's tough.
I will put you in the place that is most appropriate. Yes, sir.
What if nobody tries out for a solo?
Oh, I don't think there's a problem. I can already tell by the way some of y'all are singing this that you're really into this song, and I think we'll have some people try it out. Okay. All right. Does anybody else have questions about how this everybody learns all.